Welcome to Bexbug Out Survivor, and today, December the 6th, 2016, going up to the top of the ridge, and we're going to open up the birthday present. It's the birthday unwrapping in the woods episode, and it's the Crusader. It's the Mark II Crusader. So, well earned cup of tea, I think. And every year this climb, I'm sure it gets steeper. Now I know the BCB Crusader, bit slippy here underground, is not new out on the market or anything, but I'm going to compare it to a bit of kit. I've already got the BCB and the American style canteen. Let's pick up the pace here a bit, get away from these tree felling machines. Okay, one hammock coming up. Do you know, I've actually got sweat on. I need a drink of water. I'll show you what I've been bringing my water out in before the opening of the birthday present. Even my American version here is a copy. I have the original at home, but this is again a good copy, and it would have come with a carry sack and day canteen. Okay, I'm going to dive in pack, I'm going to open up the present, and I'm actually going to have a little go of it. I want to see if I can at least make a lovely hot chocolate, plenty of sugar, and after that, well, I've already had breakfast, but I'll make some of my rations up. Okay, now this is from Mrs. Beck's. And I always pretty much get what I want every year. Do love my birthday. Got to admit. Oh, here we are. Comes in a brown envelope. Move the paper. Good. Rip this open here. Oh, lovely. Well, do you know, I've always wondered the size of it. And there is the BCB Crusader Mark II. Does have the molly attachment. And there's the full setup. Do you know, I haven't even got my glasses to see if this is an original. I put my glasses down for a minute and they've gone. One of these bottles, a replacement, is only £9. Now the actual burner itself at the bottom and cup were £20. So the burner itself, or windshield, separately about £20. Only £9 for the bottle. Again, another £20 for the, if you want the cooking cup. I haven't priced up a separate stuff sack or beaker, plastic beaker. And I've also bought some hexamine blocks. Do you know where everywhere I go I seem to lose my glasses? So I don't know what's going on, I'm blind as a bat. This would be the old style BCB stove. There you go. And you just put your hexamine blocks in there. If I was to put an alcohol burner on. I think the cup would sit far too close. Very sooty way of doing it, and I expect it's going to be a very sooty way of doing it in the BCB as well. Now there's, see that, an indentation circular where the spirit burner fits just perfectly. I then loop this handle back over and that will form a stand. I'm just going to pour enough water and have a drink first into the BCB cup Mark II. It will have increments on the inside and the outside. Again, totally blind to this one. I'm just going to go up to the first little level there. See that first notch? I'd estimate that was a cup that you'd have at home if you were to make yourself a nice cup of tea. So that's how much water I'm having. I'm having hot chocolate, by the way. Just open up the spirit burner. And this goes like billy-o. I have a spare lighter as well. Alright then. Well, that's going straight away. I'm just going to let that bloom. These are the original BCB hexamine tablets. A lot of people don't like them. A lot of people don't like the hexamine blocks because they say they stink and they're poisonous. But you know, it's my birthday today and I've survived last 25 years off one of these. As it is a guy who hand makes some lids for the cup, but he does want a tenner. That's 10 UK pounds. I'm going to test the quality of the bottle. I haven't got any water in it now because I'm using the American version. Has no ring seal in. I don't know if there's going to be any leakage with that. It's tough. I can't bend that and I doubt it will crack. There is a warning not to put it directly too close to the heat or on the heat. Come on, boil. No, there's no spillage from that. It's taking its time boiling. Oh, there's a bit of smoke, a bit of... Now, the thing is with the BCBs, terribly, terribly sooty using solid fuel. So I'd like to see now what the deal is with this guy here. Look at him. He's going off on a tangent there. The wind's got behind that. I can put this kit away. Actually, do you know I'm not going to put these away just yet because although these get slated, they do work. And when it sucks up, a few leaves, I can find some on the ground. Some moss, make a really great cleaning aid to this. I'm getting flamed out here. Flamed out with no bubbles. I'm not going to put a timer on this either. It's just going to be done when it's done. I should imagine it's going to take a good few minutes. Actually, I'm going to put my pack round it like a windshield. Second thoughts, no, I'm not. I've changed the fuel of what I use into my spirit burners, akin to rocket fuel, the brew making kit. I have sugar. Sugar is in that silver thing. Hot chocolate tea bags. Hot chocolate today. All that fuel from the spirit burner is gone. A little clean with moss and leaves gets all that soot off. that's the fuel from a pressure burner, you know, like your Colburn's fuel and things like that. I think the little pink liquid we have here in the UK is going to be good enough. I'm just going to jump in the hammock. I need to lie down, boy. Now, I'm going to remove that deadly spirit burner, which has now burnt the inside ring there, the rubber in it. Look at that, it's used a whole tank up, flaring up like that. I'm not going to do that again. I will be using the proper methylated spirits. But now, what I want to do in the bottom of here is to use the proper hexamine blocks from my old BCB. Don't try and light it like that in the thing, it's useless. Just burn a corner. It's just starting, so I'm going to let that catch a lot more. I've got some porridge oats. I've only had toast from this morning. I haven't got a lot of water left, so I'm going to save some. I'm going to leave the hexamine blocks out, just in case it takes more than one to do this. There is a flame there. I'll show you. Okay, here it is at a boil. Neither did I time it. I got bored of timing it, but it wasn't long. I have some porridge oats in here with some soft apricots. I've put some other stuff in, like prunes and all the goodness. I just make a little island on the top. That's when I know how I've got enough, and carry on boiling it. Still loads left, enough for another two meals there, and try and get a spoon together. I've lost all my cutlery as well. I've spilt the water once. Stir that with my coffee spoon. It's working the treat. A bit of sugar and a bit of milk powder, you know, the coffee whitener you have. I used to put coffee whitener in the water instead of using milk, and plenty of sugar. As it is, it's bog standard water and porridge oats, and find a spoon. I've got breakfast, so I've had hot chocolate and a breakfast. This is bubbling away, a treat just on hexamine. How much have we got left? Another half. So half a hexamine would easily achieve a roaring boil there. The pack has been fitted with the pouch. So that's the pouch for the BCB2. It does fit, and I'm chuffed to bits with it. This is going to be my day hiking canteen of choice. Every time I want to stop and have a brew, something to eat, it's always on the front of the pack. I'm always going to carry some sort of hexamine. Oh, that's done enough. I'll see if I can retrieve. Ow! Get that for a burn. Gotta really watch yourself. Put your gloves on. And the great thing is with, oh gee whiz, look at that, it's even burnt through my wool jumper. But at least I've only got one burn on my finger. think that's gone through to the bone. Well, I'm going to have to let all this cool down. Hammock time. Hot. That's so incredibly hot. If I did want more water, if I wanted to make a cup of tea, for instance, a little later, there is a stream about a mile and a half away, and I could boil up some water. But a lesson I've learned is never use your canteen cup to gather stream water. Because even though you pour it in to your pot, your cook pot, this will still be contaminated if you pour the water, even though it's boiled, back into something like this. This has to be absolutely clean. It's best if you do find an old 2 litre pot bottle, 1 litre pot bottle out and about. Just grab it, because it will come in handy. You can scoop filthy water, boil it up in your pot, and then once it's boiled, you can put it into your little off spray bottle. I don't think that has a NATO stock pattern number on. Let's have a look. Actually, it does. Wow. And this is the cheap version of the MK2. Don't know if you can see there. There's it's NATO, all the information, and it you should be able to read off spray there. And of course, at the time, I didn't have my glasses. I've seen these advertised around 50 quid mark, 49 quid. Mrs. Bex got me that for about 42 quid, so I wasn't expecting it to be off spray. I wasn't expecting it to be the Welsh version made in Cardiff. But it all is. The MTP is a close proximity of MTP. I don't think that's an original pouch, and it even the mole system or molly system doesn't look right. I've used molly for years and years since they came out. You know, I've got molly bags, I've got dozens of them. And I lie back in my hammock, enjoy something to eat, and if it starts raining, I have got a poncho which I can improvise and rig up and even do some cooking and sanitation underneath the poncho, acting as a basher, and that'll do me. I'm gonna go home and thank Mrs. Bex for a lovely present. Get some proper fuel for it. I know people moan and moan and moan about hexamine. They're very dubious because of the arsenic in it. You know what I mean? Just suck it in. It's not going to kill you. It's only arsenic. But I have got alternatives, fuel alternatives. I'm going to try some of that Fire Dragon gel. I've already made my homemade solid fuel tabs, and they'll soot up just like hexamine, just like Fire Dragon, just like a Trangia stove. it'll soot up, so don't put it in your pack dirty. Use your leaves, your moss, it'll come off. And then when you get home, you've got even less cleaning to do. So, this has been my birthday unwrapping in the woods. Three or four, can't remember. I remember I couldn't get out once because of my bad back. And it almost didn't happen today either. But, so I'm going to down the scran, clean up, hammock away, edit the video as fast as I can, and try and get it out to you by December the 6th. So thanks for joining me. That's been the birthday unwrapping on the woods 3. This time I've opened up the Crusader cook system Mark 2, and apparently original for very little money. Until very soon, take care of yourself, and I'll see you out there.